Welcome back to the class, dear children. Today we are going to see one of the important chapters. So many questions will be coming from that. And name of the chapter is quadratic equations. Are you guys excited to solve questions on quadratic equations, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So as you know, in Kalparuksha classes, we follow step-by-step process. I kept on telling that since the starting of these classes, because always building the concepts step by step is very, very important. And we have to do that. We should keep on doing all this step by step process, then only there is a development of us. All right, dear children. So this was regarding our classroom, and today's MCQ series, SSLC MCQ series, will be based upon quadratic equations, and we'll be handling all the questions from quadratic equations. Are you excited?
Yes, sir.
All right, dear children. So let's move on to directly to the questions. Okay, direct hit questions in the board examinations. Okay, do this question now. First question is very simple. Which of the following is not a quadratic equation? You understand the meaning of quadratic equation now? What do you mean by quadratic equation? Degree should be equal to 2. Then only it is called quadratic equation. And they are asking which is not a quadratic equation. Tell me, which is not a quadratic equation? Is there anything which is not a quadratic equation? Is this a quadratic equation? Yes. 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 All are quadratic equations or not? Yes or no? And one more thing, look at this. Now these people know they make all these mistakes. I mean, in printing and all those things will happen. No need to worry at all. So this is like x cube or 3x. Tell me, x cube or x3? X cube, no, it is. Yes or no? So that equation is like x square plus x cube plus 2 equal to 0, right? So what is the degree here? The degree is like 3. So that's why it is not a quadratic equation. That's why you have to take this option. Clear? Now, if it is x3, means x square plus x3 means x into 3 plus 2 equal to 0, means definitely it becomes a quadratic equation. Now, if it is like x cube, if it is written as x cube plus 2 equal to 0, then it becomes what? Cubic equation, right, dear children? Correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, fine. So this is like a first thing, very, very clear, very simple it was. Let me move on to next thing. Tell me, what is the answer for this? The quadratic equation has degree 2, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So degree is 2. If a linear equation means, what is the degree? Linear equation means degree is 1. Cubic equation means degree is 3. Similarly, quadratic equation means degree is 2. Okay, all right. I hope it is clear. Now let me move on to next question. Third question. Do this. The cubic equation has degree 3, right?
3.
Yeah. Is my screen visible, dear children?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No. Okay. Just give me a minute. Now, just check whether is it visible now.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So yes, this is like third one. Now, fourth one. Please do this. A biquadratic equation has degree. How much is the degree of a bi? What do you mean by biquadratic equation? You need to understand this. Biquadratic equation means with two variables. Now, x square plus y square is equal to 4. Now, how many variables are there? Two variables. No, one is x, another is y, right? Yes. So basically, anything it may be, quadratic equation means degree should be 2 only. So biquadratic, triquadratic, whatever it may be, it can be x square plus y square plus z square also, triquadratic also, the degree is always 2. So that's why answer is 2. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Basically, quadratic means degree is 2. Clear, dear children? So that's why this becomes the answer. Okay? Yeah, let me move on to next question. Do this. The polynomial equation x bracket x plus 1 plus 8 equal to x plus 2 into x minus 2 is linear equation, quadratic equation, cubic equation, biquadratic equation. Definitely it's not a biquadratic equation. Why? Because only one variable is there. Okay, try to do this. x bracket x plus 1 means x into x is x square plus x into 1 is x. Then plus 8 I have written, and that is equal to x plus 2 into x minus 2 means what? A plus b into a minus b, that is a square minus b square. Here x square get cancelled. So x plus 8 equal to what is there? Minus 4 it is there. No? And it becomes x plus 8 equal to minus 4 means degree is 1. No? It is it a linear equation, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so it becomes a linear equation. Okay, it is not a quadratic equation. Quadratic equation means, as I told, degree should be equal to 2. Whatever degree you get, that should be equal to 2. Okay, all right. I hope it is clear. This is a linear equation. Let me move on to next question. Sixth question. Please do this. The equation x minus 2 whole square plus 1 is equal to 2x minus 3 is a. If you have practiced too much by looking at this only, directly you can tell it is a quadratic equation. Okay. There is no need of expansion. Also, you can expand this. A minus b whole square means it becomes a minus b whole square means what it becomes? It becomes a square plus b square minus 2ab. Minus 2ab. Then plus 1 is equal to 2x minus 3. All right. So it becomes x square plus 4 minus 4x is equal to 2x minus 3. Now, whatever happens, we are not bothered about that. Whatever it is happening, let it happen. Okay. So I think screen is visible now, dear children.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So whatever happens here, this is, look at this. So once again, x square plus 2 square minus 2ab means it becomes 4x plus 1 is equal to 2x minus 3. It has become, no. So here, anything happens with this x and x, we don't bother. But this x square means degree is 2 only. No, it becomes quadratic equation or not? Yeah, we have to see the degree of variable. Degree of polynomial means degree of a polynomial means what? Whatever variable is there, we have to see that. Now, variable x is there and its power is 2. Is it? Yes? Clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, let me move to seventh question. Do this question. The roots of the quadratic equation 6x square minus x minus 2 is equal to 0 r. Okay, find out the answer for this. Yes, 6x square minus x minus 2 equal to 0. Now, whether you want to use the quadratic formula or factorization, it is up to you. How to do the factorization, everybody knows, right? How to do the factorization? 6 into 2 or 6 into minus 2, actually it becomes minus 12. But minus 12, we don't go into minus 12. What are the factors of 12? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12, right? These are the factors. Among these, choose two numbers whose sum is like minus 1 and whose product is like minus 12. Minus 4x plus 3x will work out, no? 6x square minus 4x plus 3x minus 2 is equal to 0. Minus 4x plus 3x is minus 1, no?
Yes.
Minus 4 plus 3 means what? Minus 1. And minus 4 into 3 is minus 12. So it is satisfied. Clear? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yeah. Now in this, what you can take common? 6 and 4 is there. I can take 2 common. Then I can take x common, 2x. And in bracket, it becomes what? It becomes 3x minus 2. Correct, no? 2x common is taken means 3x minus 2. And similarly, you can write here also 3x minus 2. And that is equal to 0. And here you are going to write plus 1. Yes? So that's why you are going to write it as 2x plus 1 into 3x minus 2 is equal to 0. Then from this, you can just find out that x is equal to minus 1 by 2. Because it is going to be equal to 0, no? And here also, this will also equal to 0. That means here this one also becomes x is equal to 2 by 3. So minus 1 by 2 and 2 by 3, where it is? Here it is. Minus 1 by 2 and plus 2 by 3. Here is the answer, no? 2 by 3 comma minus 1 by 2 is also same thing. Both are same. They are not different things. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is the right answer. Very simple, no? Yeah, but you have to go as per the steps. Then only it becomes simple. Shall I go to next question?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Let me go to next question. Please do this question. The quadratic equation whose roots are 1 and. Now this question is, it is not complete here. Incomplete question it is. 1 and something they have written here. Incomplete it is. Okay. So no need to solve it. The quadratic equation whose root is 1. You just write whose root is 1 is. Find out this. The quadratic equation whose root is 1 is. Okay. Among these quadratic equation, whose root is 1? Just find out. Just take this 1 and put it here. No. 2 into 1 plus 1. That means 3. 3 minus 1 is 2. So this is not the equation. And if you do 2 into 1 square, it becomes 2. Second equation I am checking. 1 minus 1, then minus 1. That is like 2 minus 2. 2 minus 2 equal to 0 means it is satisfied. Yes, this is there. And if you come here, it becomes 2x square means third one. 2 into 1 square is 1. Plus 1 plus 1 becomes 4. So that's why it is not the root. Okay. Now if you do this, 2 into fourth one. 2 into 1 square is 1. Minus 1 plus 1 is like 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 minus 1 is 2. So it is also not correct. So answer B is correct, no? Yes or no?
Yes.
So, if they are asking like whose root is 1 means, you have to just substitute and you have to check. Correct?
Yes.
Okay. I hope it is clear. Let me go to next question. Do this question. The quadratic equation whose one rational root is 3 plus root 2 is. One of the rational roots. Both the roots will be rational only. It won't be irrational. And one root is 3 plus root 2. That means which is the quadratic equation? They're asking. Okay. See these kind of problems. No. One thing. What is the one thing you can do? You can do like... you just substitute this 3 plus root 2 in these equations and find out. That is one way. And another way, what is another way? Another way is like you solve this and find out. You solve this and find out. You solve this also and find out. This also and find out. Okay, I feel second method is fine because it is 3 root 2, no? 3 root 2 means things will go crazy there. Okay, take down this x square minus 7x plus 5 and try to do it. Yes, I think you should be able to do it. X square minus 7x plus 5 equal to 0 is there, no? Find out its root, no? Yes? Will you find out its root, dear children? See, 3 plus root 2, 1 is coming as 3 plus root 2, another must come as 3 minus root 2 or not? Tell me. 1 is coming, see, minus b plus or minus under root b square minus 4ac divided by 2a is there, no? So now everything which is there under root, that only should come as root 2, no? So that is like plus 1 and minus plus root 2 and minus root 2. So another root is like 3 minus root 2, right? Yes, dear children?
Yes.
So this question, no, actually this question is not directly from quadratic equations. This quadratic equation is linked with what? Polynomials. Do you know there is a chapter called polynomials, dear children? In 10th standard?
Yes, sir.
And this polynomials got deleted, no? For your board exam syllabus? Yes or no?
Sir.
So that's why how it is, no, dear children? The thing is like one root is 3 plus root 2, another is 3 plus root 2, another is 3 minus root 2 means the sum of the roots we find out. 3 plus root 2 plus 3 minus root 2, root 2, root 2 get cancelled and we get 6. So this sum of roots should be equal to minus b by a. There are some rules like that, minus b by a. Correct, dear children? So minus b by a means this equation becomes correct here because minus b by a, See, I know you are not going to get this because this is related to sum of roots and product of roots. Okay, sum of roots and product of roots. So this is related to polynomials. All right, dear children. So that's why no need to, take tension because of such questions, because quadratic equation and polynomials, they cannot be separated. They are same chapters. But in quadratic equation, let me make it very clear to you. In quadratic equation, whatever questions roam around in our syllabus of board exam, what you are going to write, one is due to discriminant. You are going to face those questions. Now, don't worry about this 9 question. Okay. If we do only with the help of quadratic equation chapter, it becomes very lengthy. We have to take help of that chapter, polynomial. So that's why you are not solving this question right now. Discriminant you have to think about, then you have to think about solution. Okay, then you have to think about degree, then you have to think about number of solutions. All right, because quadratic equation and polynomials are mixed together. So many questions on the internet, they are mixed together. That's why no need to worry about this question, dear children. Have faith in me. Okay, this question, if you just solve by quadratic equation, it becomes very lengthy. If you use polynomials, it becomes very short. Is it clear, dear children?
Yes.
So that's why, what is the method you tell me? The quadratic equation whose one rational root is 3 plus root 2 means, how to do it? You find out this root. Just check whether 3 plus root 2 is there or not. You find out this root and check. You find out this root and check. You find out this root and check. This becomes lengthy, no? So that's why we cannot do it by that method. So that there is something called sum of roots. Now it is in the form of which form they are? Ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, they are, no? So b is minus 6, no? Sum of the roots. Sum of the root means one root is 3 plus root 2, another root is 3 minus root 2. That should be equal to minus b by a. That's how it should be. There is one rule like that. Sum of the roots of quadratic equation is equal to minus b by a. So if you just cancel them, it becomes 6, no? Minus of b means what is there? Last equation. Minus 6 is there. Minus of minus 6 divided by a means what is there? 1. So that's why it becomes 6 by 1, no? So this equation satisfied. That's why this is the answer. Now I did not use the concept of quadratic equation here. I use the concept of polynomials. Clear, dear children?
Yes, sir.
So that's why please don't worry about this question. Have faith. This question, this kind of question will not come into your exams. There are so many. That's why I have skipped in the, as I proceed in these questions, you'll get to know about that. Okay. Don't worry about this 9 question. Now let us go to 10 question. Okay. Now do this. Now these kind of questions will come in your exams. That will also come 9th. But when polynomials is also there, then that kind of question will come. Now for you guys, it won't be coming. Corona batch. Yeah. The equation 2x square plus kx plus 3 equal to 0 has 2 equal roots. Then the value of kx. Equal roots means you understand, no? What do you mean by equal roots? That is like b square minus 4ac should be equal to 0, no? Then only it will have equal roots, no? Yeah?
Yes,
tell me. Yeah. So b is like k square minus 4 into a is like 2 and c is like 3, that is equal to 0, and it becomes k square minus 4 2s are 8, 3s are 24 is equal to 0. Then k square is equal to 24, k is equal to under root 24. Under root 24 means how we can write it? Under root 4 into 6, so that becomes plus or minus 2 root 3, no? Yes or no? Sorry, 2
yes,
root
sir.
3, no, not 2 root 3. 2 root 6, no? 2 root 6. Plus or minus 2 root 6. Here is the answer. Yeah? Clear, no? Simple, right? Tell me, dear children, simple or not?
Yes.
Yeah. So, this is a very simple thing which you can solve very easily, 10 question. Now, based on these kind of questions, you should concentrate on. Shall I go to next question?
Yes.
Yeah. Now, directly, yes, please do this. The roots of quadratic equation x plus 1 by x equal to 3, where x is not equal to 0. Now, x plus 1 by x means first you have to convert this into standard form. Now, x plus 1 by x equal to 3 means here will be 1. What is the LCM here? X is the LCM. This is 1 into x and it is x into 1. X into x is x square. X square plus 1 is equal to 3. Now x square plus 1 is equal to 3x. You bring this 3x this side. It becomes x square minus 3x plus 1 equal to 0, no? Yes or no? X square minus 3x plus 1 equal to 0. Now, can you use the quadratic formula here, dear children? If you use quadratic formula, what will be the solution for this? Minus b. B is minus 3. Minus of minus 3 means it becomes plus 3. Okay? 3 plus or minus. Under root. B square minus 4 is means b square is minus 3 square means 9. B square minus 4 ac. 4 into 1 into 1, that is like 4, and divided by 2a. 2 into 1 is like 2. So what it becomes? It becomes x is equal to 3 plus or minus root 5 divided by 2. So 3 plus or minus root 5 by 2 or 3 minus root 5 divided by 2. So this is the right option, no? C. Simple, no? Tell me, dear children, did you get this question or not? Yes. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yeah. Shall I go to next question? Okay. The roots of quadratic equation 2x square minus 2 root x plus 1 is equal to 0 r. Do this. x square minus 2 root 2x plus 1 equal to 0. Just use the quadratic formula directly here, no? So x is equal to what it becomes? Minus b. I mean 2x square minus 2 root 2x is there, no? Minus b means minus of minus 2 root 2 means it becomes plus 2 root 2. First of all, minus b plus or minus. Correct, no? Because already 2x square minus 2 root 2x means b is minus 2 root 2. Minus of minus means it becomes plus there. Plus or minus under root. B square means what it comes? Minus 2 root 2 whole square. This is b square. Minus 4ac means 4 into 2 into 1. 4, a means 2 and c means 1. Then divided by 2a. 2 into 2 is 4. A is 2, no? 2 into 2 is 4. I hope it is clear to everyone. Then what it becomes? X is equal to 2 root 2 plus or minus under root. 2 square is 4. Root 2 square is 2. Then 4 into 2 is like 8. 8 minus 8 it has become. 8 minus 8 means 0 only. Then divided by 4. So x is equal to what it becomes? It becomes 2 root 2 divided by 4. That is like 2 1s are 2 2s are. Root 2 by 2. Anything is there? Root 2 by root 2 divided by 2? Nothing is there. How you can do it? Root 2 divided by 2 can be written as root 2 into root 2. So root 2 get cancelled. 1 by root 2. So 1 by root 2 and 1 by root 2. Because it has become 0 means only one root will be there. Two roots and same roots. They are 1 by root 2 and 1 by root 2, no? Look at this. We got it as 1 by root 2 or not. How is this question? Very beautiful design, no, dear children? Tell me, did you understand this? Deepthi, Nisarga, Srujan, Pavan, Raghavendra, Vinayak?
Yes, sir.
Did you understand this?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yeah. All right. Good. Awesome. Let me see how many have come. I think only 6 have joined. Sai Prasad, are you understanding, Sai Prasad?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. All right. Fine, dear children. Afterwards, many are watching videos and they are not coming to class. Okay. Do this question. If one of the roots of quadratic equation 2x square plus kx minus 6 equal to 0 is 2, the value of k is. I mean 2 is the root of this equation. Whatever 2 is there, no, that is a root of the equation 2x square plus kx minus 6 equal to 0. Then they are asking k value. How to do it? 2x square plus kx minus 6 equal to 0 is there, no? So what do you do? You find out, I mean, instead of this x, you put 2 because 2 is a root, no? 2 into 2 square plus k into again x is like 2 minus 6 equal to 0. Then 2 into 2 square means 2 into 4, that is 8, no? 8 plus 2k minus 6 equal to 0. Then it becomes a 2k is equal to 6 minus 8. Because minus 6 means plus 6, 8 means minus 8. So 2k is equal to minus 2 and 2 to get cancelled and k equal to minus 1. The value of k is going to be minus 1. Is this understood, dear children? Simple?
Yes, sir.
So, one doubt you must be having. That doubt is like, why directly question number 21 came? In between questions, where they went? All those questions, what were there in between? They were all related to polynomials also. In polynomials, there is a concept of sum of roots and product of roots. And you won't be solving them by using quadratic equation. If you solve also, it will become very lengthy. That's why I have avoided all those questions. As polynomials is not there for your syllabus in this year. Clear, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yeah. That's why better to avoid the questions which are linked with polynomials. So that's why directly from this question I have come here. Okay. Now again 23 I have come. Why? 22 where it went? It went because it is linked with polynomials. Do this. The roots of, now these kind of questions will come in your board exam. The roots of equation 7x square plus x minus 1 equal to 0 are. Find out b square minus 4ac, no? Then you will get to know. B square means 1 square. Minus 4 into a is 7. C is minus 1. Then it becomes 1 plus 28. So 1 plus 28 means 29. It is greater than 0. Greater than 0 means real and different roots. Real and distinct, no. Real and distinct means, yes. Real and equal, no. Not real, no, none of this. Real and distinct. Distinct means different only, no? I mean, unique they are. So that's why this is the correct option. These are wrong. This is correct option. Understood, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Based upon this b square minus 4ac, definitely questions will come. Equal to 0, less than 0, greater than 0. There will be questions. Because one of the simple concepts it is, that's why question may be asked. Now do this. The equation 12x square plus 4kx plus 3 equal to 0 has real and equal roots. Yes. It should have real roots. When do they have real roots, dear children? When b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, then only they will have real roots, no? So b is means what? B is like a 4k. 4k whole square minus 4 into a is 12. Into c is 3, that is equal to 0. 4k whole square is 16k square. Then minus 4 into 3, 12. 12 into 12, 144. 144 is equal to 0. Then it becomes 16k square is equal to 144. Then k is equal to 144 divided by 16. 16 ones are 16 8s are. Correct, no? 16 8s are 144 or not? I don't know. Just check. 6 is 48. I don't think so. Okay. Just check this, no? Otherwise, you can cancel it. 4 4s are. Then 4 3s are 12. Then 2 is the carry. I think 9 sa it is 44. Yeah. Then 6 are. 4 1s are. 4 9s are. Sorry. 16 9s are 144 it is. Okay. So k is equal to what it comes? Sorry. K square. K square is equal to what it is coming? 9. Then k is equal to root 9 means. Plus or minus 3. Plus or minus 3 means this answer. No? Correct, no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, I think 24th answer is also very, very clear to all of you. Did you get this, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sir. So basically based upon this, sir, the finding the value of k from this b square minus 4ac equal to 0 is one more famous question from this chapter which you should be practicing. All right. Now let me move to next question. Do this. If minus 5 is a root of the quadratic equation 2x square plus px minus 15 equal to 0, then p equal to 3, p equal to 5, p equal to 7, and p equal to 1. Two x square plus px minus 15 equal to 0. Minus 5 is a root, they are saying. Minus 5 is a root means 2 into minus 5 whole square plus p into minus 5 minus 15 is equal to 0. 2 into minus 5 whole square is 25. Minus 5p minus 15 equal to 0 means 2 into 25 is 50. 50 minus 5p minus 15 equal to 0. 50 minus 15 is 35. 35 minus 5p is equal to 0. Let us send 5p that side. 35 is equal to 5p. P is equal to 7. No, this is the correct answer. No, yes. P equal to 7 or not? Yeah,
yes, okay. Sir.
So I think everybody got it. Dear children, by looking at this chapter, quadratic equation in two variables, what you are feeling, where the questions are roaming around, if you see all these questions, whatever we have solved till now, they're all roaming around. One is like solution. Solution of quadratic equation you have to find out. And next one, they are asking about nature of roots. Nature of roots, whether they're nature of roots, whether real roots, real and distinct roots, unique roots or same roots, all that. Nature of roots. Next one is about this finding value of k, finding find k and p. So based upon these three models only questions will be framed. I mean, there won't be any other chance of finding other simple question. What is the degree of quadratic equation? Okay, what is the degree of linear equation, quadratic equation, cubic equation? And they may ask you how many zeros are there for number of zeros for quadratic equation. What are the number of zeros for quadratic equation, dear children? Number of zeros for quadratic equation is 2 or not? Yes or not? Two solutions will be there. Two zeros will be there for quadratic equation. What is the degree? Those many zeros will be there. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? Tell me, dear children. Are you able to hear me or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So these are the questions from quadratic equation, dear children. So you keep practicing all these quadratic equation questions from wherever you get. Okay. From whichever chapter you get, you keep on practicing. And by end of the session, I think 19th, you have exam now. On 17th, I am going to conduct on 40 marks mathematics test. 40 marks of mathematics test on all chapters, whatever chapters, including construction and all. Okay, everything will come on 7. Is it okay? 19th is the 17th is okay, right?
Yes, sir.
If 17th, 40 mark test is there, immediately I will provide the answers also after the test. So that you can, I mean, here only test will be uploaded and you will get to know your score on which area you have to concentrate on by 17th, 12 o'clock. You will understand that. And from 17th, you can study that. On 18th also you can study, so that on 19th, those mistakes will be rectified. Is that clear, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes. And science test will be before that. Now, what is today's date? Today's date is 10, no? So we are left with another how many days? 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Another 6 days are remaining. Now in that I have to cover what and what? Construction has to be covered. There again what has to be covered? Surface areas and volumes. Is there any chapter remaining? Just remind me, dear children. As I know, construction and surface areas and volumes are the only chapters which are remaining. Clear? Is there any other chapter? Please remind me. No other chapter. As I know. Tell me, sir. Dear children. Yeah. Next, now in this thing, electricity is there, then light is there, then magnetic effects of electric current is there, then sources of energy are there. Sources of energy is very simple. Okay, very few things will be there, and all these things are also simple only, but still we have to practice them. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 chapters and 7 days, and one day will be cut in that. So I'll be combining this electricity and magnetic effects of electric current, because so many questions are mixed up here in electricity and magnetic effects of electric current. So in 6 days, in the next 6 days, everything will be completed. Okay, dear children?
Yes.
On 17th, morning we'll have mathematics test. Morning we'll have mathematics test, and in the evening we'll have science test. Is that all right? Science means physics test. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So that on 18th and 19th, 17th afternoon, evening onwards, and 18th also, you will have time to rectify all your doubts. Okay, dear children.
Yes, sir.
Throughout the year, you have studied all the concepts. All the concepts have become crystal clear to you. Now it is like a revision session. It is not like teaching session. These are just to, do the revision, just to imbibe the vibe, so that things become very clear to you. All right, dear children. Yes. Tell me. Tell me, dear children. Okay, fine, then nobody is talking now. Thank you very much for joining the class. I'll be joining with you in the next class. Take care, have a good day. Bye bye.
Bye, sir.
Bye,
sir.
Bye bye.